So we're going to talk about a different clustering algorithm that at least doesn't have that weird property, and it has some other nice positive properties, but there's trade-offs. There's always trade-offs in clustering. So k-means clustering is what we're going to talk about next, and the basic flow of the algorithm is like this. We're going to first pick a k. K is going to be the number of clusters that we're going to try to produce, and the way it's going to do it is by picking k of the points at random to be centers. And then we're going to repeat the following process. Each center is going to claim its closest points. So we're going to cluster all the points based on how close they are to the k centers that we've defined. Then we're going to recompute, based on that clustering that we just did, recompute the centers, and the center will be the average of the points in its cluster. And then we're going to tick-tock back and forth. We're going to go back and repeat until convergence for the new centers claiming their closest points, the new groups of points computing their average, and back and forth like that. So let's step through an example, and then we'll try to analyze what this actually does.
Okay, that makes sense.
All right, I'm going to do k equals 2 in this example, the same set of points that I used in the previous example. And I'll just, I don't know, kind of randomly choose two of them to be the two clusters, the red cluster and the green cluster. All right?
Okay.
So that's this first step done. Now what we're going to do is each of these centers is going to claim their closest point. So we're going to take all the points in the space and assign them to one or the other of these two clusters. And it ends up looking like this. All right? So this is now the points that are closest to the green center have all been put into a green blob. The ones that were closest to the red center all get put into the red blob.
Okay.
So that's step two. Now what we do is recompute the centers. So the center of the red blob is still pretty close to where it was before. But if you look at the green blob, the center of the green blob ought to be a little bit more to the right. You see that?
I do. In fact, it should be a lot more to the right because there's a whole lot of points on the right.
Yeah, though I did this sort of by eye, so it doesn't, yeah, you're right. It should be closer to the clump on the right, but I didn't quite do it that way.
Okay.
So I moved it just a little bit more to the right. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
But now we can repeat this process. We could say, okay, now everybody join the group that you're closest to. And one nice thing that happened now is that the group of points on the left all joined together in red, and this sort of weird hammery thing on the right became green. And now we're going to recompute our centers again. We're going to say, well, where's the center of the clusters given the way that they've been painted? And that, again, moved things a little bit to the right in both cases. We ask every point to join the team that they're closest to, and we get that. And that actually turns out to be exactly the same clustering that we had a moment ago. So when we recompute the centers, they remain unchanged. And so we've converged. So it seems to have clustered things reasonably, given that I didn't actually run this. I just did it by hand.
Okay. Can I ask a question? You seem to have drawn...
Oh, please.
Okay. You seem to have drawn this in such a way that the centers are always one of the points. But that's not really what you meant to do, is it? Or rather,
no,
that's not always
the case.
No,
it's definitely not. No. It's definitely not what I meant to do. It really is just, the center is not necessarily a point that's in the collection of objects.
Right.
Yeah. Thanks for pointing that out.
Okay. So this makes sense. And that looked better than what single linkage clustering or single link clustering or single linkage or whatever it is called, clustering did.
At least for this kind of example, yeah. It produced kind of more compact clusters without giant holes in them.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have any questions about this, about what it does?
Yes. So I think I might have some questions, Michael. And they may even be questions you'd like to hear. So I asked one question about what the centers would look like. So I have a couple of questions. One is, does this always converge? Does it always come up with a good answer?
Yeah, those are good questions.